Hi, this is Grandma Susan, or Mom, and today we're going to learn how to make chocolate roll. So here we go with chocolate roll. I am going to start the oven. You can hear my oven going. This new oven cooks a little bit hot, so the oven is supposed to be at 375 and I'm setting it at 350. Now, it takes as much time to make two chocolate rolls as it does to make one chocolate roll. So I'm doubling everything today, but I'll give you the ingredients actually just for one chocolate roll. Grandma's original recipe that you'll find in Aunt Barbara's cookbook calls for 4 eggs. I've increased it to the 6 eggs, but today, since we are doing 2, we're going to do 12 eggs. So we've got quite a few eggs to break. Egg whites are going into the Bosch because we're going to have to whip our egg whites, separately from our yolks. So egg whites are going into the Bosch and egg yolks are going into my little red bowl here. So these are lovely brown eggs. I don't know where you got these.
I got them just up the street. They're cage-free ones.
Oh, well, there you have it. Okay, we're going to beat up these eggs until they're fluffy and white. And once they get fluffy, then we're going to fold in the sugar. So I'm going to turn these back on. We add 1 1/8 cups of sugar. While I'm working on that, I'm going to beat up the egg yolks. In Aunt Barbara's recipe, you'll see she says to beat the egg yolks until they look like lemon. The vanilla goes right into the egg yolk. Just about the time you have the egg yolks ready, your egg whites should be nice and stiff. Our egg whites are nice and stiff. It could be stiffer, but it's okay. It'll work just fine. And now we're gonna fold in, trying not to lose any of the air we got in our eggs. I probably put the sugar in a little too early, but it will work. I watch cooking shows. It drives me crazy when they don't clean out their bowl. I just feel like they're wasting so much stuff. Now we're ready to blend up our dry ingredients, and I've got them already over here. It's 6 tablespoons of flour. Of course, this is doubled. 9 tablespoons of flour, 6 tablespoons of cocoa, some baking powder, and a little bit of salt. Okay, and you can see how easily this just sifts. So here we have our dry ingredients, and they're all sifted together. And now we're just going to fold them into our eggs. See, it's really a light, light batter. Okay. Now I'm just going to divide this batter up between the 2 pans. It's okay for the batter not to go clear to the ends of the pan. We don't cook this very long. It cooks in 12 minutes. What we're going to do is when we take it out of the oven, we are going to drop the chocolate roll onto a damp wash dish towel. Yeah, this is good. Beautiful. Okay, so we're going to loosen it from the outside edge, and I'm going to show you the best way ever to turn it out. Cloth, put it right up here, feels. Ouchy. Go. Now, we're on the damp cloth. While it's still hot, it'll peel off. If you let it cool too much, your paper is gonna stick to the cake as you pull it off, and then you're gonna lose half your cake. So, which thing we don't want to do, since we've spent so much time making it so beautiful and lovely. And so now, turn it, decide how to roll it. Now, I roll it this way.
So you roll it before you have cream in it.
Yep, and I'm gonna put it in the fridge just like this. We'll cool it, and when it's cool, then we take it out. We'll take it out, unroll it, put the cream in it, roll it back up. You do not be tempted to put any sweetener in the cream, because it's really the unsweetened cream with the with the sweet chocolate sauce that makes the dessert. And if you sweeten the cream, you ruin the dish. If you're not a dame, if you've never had it before, you think, oh, surely I can improve on it. But that's really the beauty of it. And we've had cousins that weren't Dayton cousins throw their chocolate roll away because it just didn't taste right to them. But this is the way you do it, and you can't mess it up. You're gonna, for that size chocolate roll, you're going to whip 2 cups of cream. One thing I don't do, in our sauce it asks for rich milk. Well, I don't drink rich milk. We've maybe used 2%, or now I'm drinking skim milk. So I save the things that my cream comes out of, and then I use it to measure my milk, and then the extra cream goes into the milk and makes my milk rich. So that's how I do it. Okay, so we're gonna whip this cream. It's gonna whip up really fast. One year I was making chocolate roll for Brandon's birthday, and we actually ended up with butter because I walked away and didn't pay attention to the cream that I was whipping. So I had to whip some more, but we did have fresh butter, and you know Brandon, he loves butter. So, one of the good things about the box. Beautiful. Now remember, this isn't sweet, but it will be. Okay, we're gonna get started with our sauce. Now, you're not making very much sauce, but it boils over, and I've probably made more sauce. I've made enough sauce for twice as many chocolate rolls as I've made in my life. You can use cocoa, or you can use Nestle's Quick. But Nestle's Quick makes your sauce a little smoother. So I'm gonna use 6 tablespoons of Nestle's to 1.5 cups of sugar. 4, 5, 6. It's something I always have in my home storage anyway, so we're good to go. And then I'm adding 1 cup of...
You don't have the heat on yet.
Rich milk, I know. Fill this chocolate roll with cream, but we want it, when we unroll it, we want it to land right on our on our serving plate. We're going to roll it up. Thank you. And that is how you make a chocolate roll. And I'm having mine for breakfast. Bon appetit. Oh, delicious. Not for guilty pleasure. I have had such a good and easy life, and I've gotten to travel the world. I've had this amazing opportunity to teach children's dance, which I thoroughly loved and had great experiences with these wonderful, you know, little girls and doing those creative things, and all the creative things I did there could just spill over with you guys because you love doing, you know, creative things. And so that was a wonderful time. I've had my experiences with PTA were just so rewarding. And I just learned so much. And the women I worked with were just the salt of the earth. I never ran into anybody who seemed like they were self-serving and trying to, you know, push themselves forward. They're just always good people doing good things. That's been a great experience. And my experience with the Worldwide Organization for Women has been, well, PTA was a spiritual experience too. It was very much, I felt like I was directed by my Father in Heaven to what I needed to do and to have the strength to do it and be able to say the right things and be in the right places. And wow, it was even more so because so many times and get on my knees before I would get up from my knees, sometimes the phone would ring and it would be somebody with an, you know, an answer to what I'd been praying about. And it was just so, it's hard to even explain to someone because, but it just happened so many times that I felt like I couldn't ever walk away from wow, because it was like the Lord said, no, it needs to be, you've got to get these women in places where they can be rubbing shoulders with other women. I always have said, if you're not at the table, you're on the menu.
I was thinking this morning, it was a thought that came into my mind that you had all sons and it allowed you to make every woman you met one of your daughters, you know?
Maybe so. Maybe I was just kind of hungry for sisters and for other women, so I've become, you know, friends with lots of good women over the years. I mean, when I was first diagnosed with cancer, and you know, people said, well, now you're going to kind of have to focus and decide what you really want to do. And I looked at my life and I thought, no, I'm really doing what I feel like I need to do.